Well, I came here in 1962 as a Nick wannabe and stood on the street in Grant Avenue here in Panhandle the Tourist and looked for the remnants of what had been the beat movement. But one of the institutions of that time was Peter Macchiarini, of course, and his studio. And just over the years, we've had many encounters. I've produced a lot of events in the Bay Area. I had the Family Dog in the Avalon Ballroom, and I produced the big Summer of Love event a couple of years ago out in the park. But it's to Peter, to whom we owe a lot of the credit for the street fairs and basically for having carved a way for any of us to really exercise our constitutional rights to public assembly. I mean, we've always had these rights, but sometimes people have to stand up for them and say, hey, these are our rights, and have to fight for them, and Peter did for all of us.
What kind of legacy has that carried on?
Well, I think you can see it in the love and the friendship and the number of people who've shown up here, you know, to honor him on his, it's a little 90th birthday, I believe, but in any event, it's a wonderful celebration that, one, he's survived this long and that he's still a thinking, caring, loving person now.
What is it that you found when you came here to North Beach? And what was it, first of all, you were looking for, and what do you think that you found once you got here?
Well, I'm not sure I found what I was looking for here. In many ways, I think it had become quite commercialized by the time I got here and so on. And I kind of moved out to the Haight-Ashbury and became part of the whole hippie thing, if you will, or whatever. But, San Francisco has had a marvelous bohemian tradition, really, from 1849 to the present, you know. And Peter's one of the true historical figures in that, I think.
What's the definition of bohemian?
Bohemian? Someone who lives their life for art's sake, I would say, for the to be part of the creative process. And that's always been indulged and supported and financed to some degree here, right from the gold rush days. Typically, places that are supportive of these kind of communities tend to be port cities with their international ports of call. You know, I mean, here we are at the convergence of Chinatown and North Beach and so on. You know, the convergence of cultures always lends itself to that kind of bohemian atmosphere, I guess. You know?
What was it like back then? Peter was living with the community of artists that were here, you know, back when the Monkey Block was here. And
well, I'm not quite that old. The Monkey Block was kind of gone by the time I'm an art dealer in my present incarnation, as it were. And so I know a lot about that period. I know about 730 Montgomery and the Monkey Block and Maynard Dixon and Ralph Stackpole and Diego Rivera and Frida Kahlo, who all lived up and down in here and that's here and that sort of thing.
And what is it about Peter's work that's so captivating?
Well, I think his work kind of transcends. I mean, it's stuff that contemporary people, in a sense, it's not dated. You know?